In this video, we're going to be checking out isometric views and elliptical arcs. So we've got a new drawing for you that you can download from the library to follow along with this particular video. It's called isometricview.dwg. When you open up the file, you should be in the model tab and you should be able to see two red vertical lines. And you should be in the layers panel here on the layer isometric. If you're not, just click on the drop down and select isometric like so. What we're going to do, we're going to create an isometric view of a cylinder using an ellipse and an elliptical arc. So let's get through that quickly and easily, and you'll see how easy this is to do to create a simple isometric view. So we're going to go over to the draw panel on the home tab. We're going to go to the ellipses like we did in the previous video, click on the down arrow, and we're going to use axis end. Click there like so. One axis end will be this endpoint snap here. Make sure your object snaps are on. Click once, drag the axis to this endpoint, click again like so. Now you can see there as we move the mouse that the top face of the cylinder is there, but we need to position it. If you look at the command line, you can see that there is a sub option there of rotation. Right click and select rotation on the shortcut menu and type in 60 degrees. Because what you're doing now is you're rotating your circle on the top of the cylinder through 60 degrees isometrically. So just type in 60 and enter. There's the top of your isometric view of your cylinder. And it's accurate as well because AutoCAD's calculated all of that for you. Okay, we go back now to the draw panel. Click on the flyout again for ellipses and select elliptical arc. Now, what we've got to do here is go for the axis endpoint of the elliptical arc, as it says on the prompt there on the dynamic input. So you can do an axis end elliptical arc, or you can do a center elliptical arc in the same way as you can draw ellipses. Notice on the command line, there's a sub option there of center. If I right click and select center, it gives me the center option to create an elliptical arc. I don't want that in this case. I want to use endpoints because I've got my two vertical lines. So I'm going to go to the left-hand endpoint, left-click, just like I did with the ellipse when we started out, and go to this endpoint here and left-click. So you'll notice there, look, there's an ellipse there, but I need to right-click first and select rotation, just like I did for the ellipse. Again, 60 degrees, because we want it to obviously look the same as the one above on the top face of the cylinder. Press enter to confirm. So now we need to specify the start angle of our elliptical arc. How does that work? Well, remember, AutoCAD measures angles and also arcs counterclockwise. So we need to go counterclockwise here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start at the left-hand end, click, and just drag around, and then go to the endpoint again and click, and there's my elliptical arc. And if I zoom out slightly, there's my little isometric view of my cylinder, utilizing an ellipse at the top and an elliptical arc at the bottom between my two vertical lines. It's a very quick little isometric view, but you can see how you can utilize your geometry and the ellipses and the elliptical arc to create an isometric view quickly and easily.